Sairam children, so we are back again today with our English revision, and today we are going to do revision in composition. Yes, in composition we had learnt two topics. Which were the topics that we learnt? We learnt essay writing and dialogue writing. Yes, do you all remember? We learnt essay writing and dialogue writing. So, what were the steps that we had to remember while writing essay, or what were the steps we had to remember while writing dialogues? We're going to see that. So, let's have a quick recap of what we have done earlier. Yes? What is an essay? An essay is a long connected piece of written composition on a given topic. Yes? Any topic that is given to you, you write a long piece of connected, that is each sentence is connected to the other sentence, and you write it in paragraphs. There has to be a minimum of 3 paragraphs, right? We have learned that. It is a composition made up of several paragraphs. Minimum there has to be 3, and it can be more than 3 also. Each of these paragraphs has a collection of connected sentences on a given topic. All these paragraphs are written based on the topic given to you. Okay? So let's see again here, as I said, the type of questions that will come in your exam. I'm going to show it over here. We have to choose the correct answer. That means 2 options are given. You have to select the correct option by clicking on the option. So read the sentence maybe 2 times, 3 times, understand what is asked, and then click the correct answer. Okay, now let's see here. An essay has a dash and a minimum of 3 paragraphs. As I said earlier, an essay has minimum of 3 paragraphs, right? And one more thing, what do we write? Has a title or a moral? An essay has a title. We always give a title to the essay. The first thing that we do is we give a title to the essay. So let's select title. So an essay has a title and a minimum of 3 paragraphs. Understood? Let's see the next one. And dash in an essay introduces a topic to the reader. I said essay is written in paragraphs, and we said minimum of 3 paragraphs. So what are the different parts of an essay? We have learnt there is a beginning, the middle portion, and an end. Yes, so beginning is the introduction, then you have the body, which is the main portion, and the end, that is the conclusion. So what does the introduction do? It introduces the topic to the reader. That means what are we going to write about? It gives an introduction of that. So here, which is the correct answer? And dash in an essay introduces the topic to the reader. So what introduces the topic? Introduction or conclusion? Introduction, right? An introduction in an essay introduces the topic to the reader. So let's whatever you have learned, the steps involved in writing an essay, you have to remember them, you have to learn them, remember them, and recollect, and then you click the correct answer. The next one, the dash of an essay is the main section of an essay and always follows the introduction. As I said, there are 3 sections, the beginning, the middle portion, and the end. The beginning, we said, is the introduction. What will come after introduction? The body, which is the main section of an essay, right? So which is the correct answer here? We'll select the body. The body of an essay is the main section of an essay, and it always follows the introduction, right? Whatever we want to write related to the topic in detail, we'll be writing it in the body of an essay. Okay, now let's go to the next one. The title of an essay should be written at the top or at the bottom. Now this is quite easy. You all know, where do we write the title? Do we write it at the top or do we write it at the bottom? Yes, we write it at the top. So let's select top. Clear till here? So let's move ahead. Now we have to read the sentence, understand it, and say whether the sentence is true or false. That means whether the sentence is right or wrong. Then we will select true. If wrong, we will select false. Okay, so choose the correct answer. The sentence is, we should use simple sentences and correct punctuation marks while writing an essay. Okay, it says we should use simple sentences and correct punctuation marks while writing an essay. Now tell me, is it true or false? It is true. We should always use simple sentences and use the correct punctuation marks while writing an essay. Yes? So let's select true. Let's go to the next one. The body of an essay marks the end of the essay. That means they're saying the body of the essay, that is the middle part of the essay, is the end of the essay. Is it true? No, we have learned there are three parts: the introduction, the body, and then comes the conclusion, which summarizes what we have written about the topic, right? So body is not the end, conclusion is the end. So tell me, this sentence is true or false? The body of an essay marks an end of the essay. Is it true or is it false? Yes, this is false. Okay, go to the next one. The body of an essay should not be more than one paragraph. Yes, the body, that is the middle part. Introduction is one paragraph. Conclusion is one paragraph. In the middle, we have the body of an essay, the main section of the essay. Now, they are saying the body of an essay should not be more than one paragraph. Is it true or false? What have we learned? Yes, we have learned the body of an essay can be more than one paragraph, right? If we want, if we have information to write, we can write two also or three paragraphs also. So this statement is false. Clear, children? The body of an essay, the middle part of an essay, can be of more than one paragraph. Yes, so this statement is wrong. This statement is false. Clear till here? I hope you all are following. Yes. The next one, the introduction in an essay can be longer than the other paragraphs. We have seen that in an essay there has to be minimum of three paragraphs: the introduction, the body, and the conclusion. Now what they are saying here is the introduction in an essay can be longer than the other paragraphs. So is it true or false? Yes, this statement is false, because the introduction is always short. We are just giving an introduction of the topic that we are going to write about what we are going to write in the body of an essay. So it has to be short. The introduction should always be short. So this statement is false. The introduction in an essay can be longer than the other paragraphs is false. Clear till here? All have understood what we are doing here? Yes. In composition also, we are going to have MCQ based questions only. You have to read the statement, understand, and select the correct option by clicking on it. Clear? Now let's move ahead. The second topic, that is dialogue writing. What is a dialogue? A dialogue is a conversation or a set of words spoken between two or more characters, right? If there are two people or more than two people, whatever they are talking among themselves, that is dialogue. Yes. Now, what are the steps that we have to keep in mind while writing the dialogue? Think about different aspects of the topic of conversation. What are the things one can speak depending on the topic given to you? Yes, so you have to think about that. Next, imagine yourself in both the characters. If there are two characters in a dialogue writing, we have to imagine ourselves in both the characters. That means we wrote the dialogue of doctor and patient, right? So we will think ourselves. Then I'll go to the patient's place and I say, if I was a patient, what will I say, right? So I have to imagine myself as a doctor also. I have to imagine myself as a patient also, and then think and write the dialogues. So imagine yourself in both the characters. Okay? The next is, think what the conversation should be according to you. Think, what can the conversation be according to you? And then accordingly plan the dialogues that you want to write. Use simple everyday language. Simple language, how you talk normally every day, use that language to write the dialogues. Yes? Use the names of the character to indicate their dialogue. How will you know this doctor is saying so and so? So we will use the names of the characters if we know, or else in the dialogue that we did, I had written doctor, then we put a colon and then I write the dialogue of the doctor. So use the names of the character to indicate their dialogue. Okay? So use a colon, that is two dots after the name of the character. So when I'm writing the name of the character followed by a colon and then I write the dialogue, it indicates that this character is speaking this. Yes, this dialogue is spoken by the character. Okay, so you have to use names of the character to indicate their dialogue. Use a colon after the name of the character. Okay. Every time a different character speaks, write the dialogue on a fresh line. Okay? Every time a different character is speaking, we will write the dialogue in a fresh line. Okay? Clear? Okay. Now let's do some examples here. Choose the correct answer. Dash involves the use of dialogues to describe the conversation between two characters. Options given are dialogue writing or essay writing. So which is the one that involves the use of dialogues to describe the conversation between two characters? Yes, it is dialogue writing. Correct? Let's move to the next one. Dash are very important part of dialogue writing. Dash are very important part of dialogue writing. Options given are characters or paragraphs. What is important in dialogue writing? Characters or paragraphs? Characters, right? Characters are very important part of dialogue writing. The next is, we should use the dash of the characters to indicate their dialogues. We should use the the dash of the characters to indicate their dialogues. What do we use? Names of the characters or address of the characters? Yes, names of the characters, right? We are using the names of the characters to indicate their dialogues. Fine. Let's go to the next one. We should use a dash after the name of the character and then write the dialogue. We should use a dash after the name of the character and then write the dialogue. So what do we use after the name of the character? Do we use a comma or do we use a colon? Yes, we will be using a colon. So we should use a colon after the name of the character and then write the dialogue. Yes? Every time a new character speaks, we should write the dialogue on a fresh line or same line? Fresh line. Correct. Every time a new character speaks, we should write the dialogue on a fresh line. Now, read the statement and tell me whether it is right or wrong. If right, click true. If wrong, click false. Okay? We should imagine ourselves in both the characters before starting to write the dialogues. We should imagine ourselves in both the characters before starting to write the dialogue. Yes, this statement is true. We just now read that. Yes? The characters in dialogue writing could be human beings, animals, inanimate objects, and can have names. The characters in dialogue writing, that means when you are writing a dialogue writing, the characters for whom you are writing dialogue, they can be human beings like us, they can be animals, they can be inanimate objects, and can have names. So is this true or false? Like we have seen, in dialogue writing between doctor and patient, so they are human beings. In the lessons we have read that the baby elephant and the colo colo bird, they are having conversation. That means they can be animals also. That it can be inanimate objects also. I can write dialogue on my imagination, right? I can write a dialogue between a chair and a table that they are talking among themselves. So it can be anything. So the characters in dialogue writing could be human beings, could be animals, could it be inanimate objects, and they can have names. Okay, so this statement is true. Clear, children? I hope you all are following this. Yes. Now the next one. It's okay to make grammatical mistakes. It's okay to make grammatical mistakes while writing dialogue. Is it okay to make mistakes, grammatical mistakes while writing dialogue? Is it okay if I don't put the punctuations? No, right? This is wrong. So let's select false. Okay, children? So clear, children? I hope you all have understood what type of questions are going to come in your exam, right? You will not have to write essay or dialogue writing for this exam because it is MCQ based. MCQs will be based on the steps of writing essay or dialogue or on the format of essay writing and dialogue writing. Okay, children, so go through this once again. All the best. We meet again tomorrow with our next revision video. Okay, bye. Sai Ram.